Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm doing a collective Pixi haul. I've been wanting to try Pixi products for a while, and I picked up a few products here and there, but the price point always set me off. So Pixi is a brand that is sold here in the States in like Target and also online, and I've heard like throughout Europe this is a drugstore brand, so like on par with like Maybelline or CoverGirl, but the prices for us here in the States are really high. They're like Sephora prices. And it's kind of an example of how like brands we take for granted here in the States are much more expensive elsewhere. So I really wanted to do a deep dive into Pixi and see like, okay, are these products actually worth their high prices? So over the past few months, past year, I mean, I've been picking up Pixi products here and there, you know, one thing here, one thing there, and trying things out slowly, but I finally decided to, you know what, jump in feet first. And I placed kind of a big haul. I mean, it's obviously not from Sephora, but I've got a lot of products in here. So I ordered all of these products within the last couple of weeks, and then my good friend Victoria had a bunch of Pixi products that she knew she wasn't really going to get to use, so she shipped me a bunch. So we're going to go through everything today just to give you a collective idea of what I have and what I'm going to be testing, because in a few weeks and or months, I really want to test these thoroughly. I don't want to just throw a video up for the sake of throwing a video up, right? I really want to test these products and tell you whether or not I think they're worth the price that they're at here in the States. So we're first going to go through everything that I purchased, and then we'll go through what Victoria sent me. So let's start with what I've picked up over the last couple of weeks, the first or months. Actually, I've had this for a while. This is the Hello LA Angel palette. So this is like a face and eye palette. So you're supposed to have like a contour, a bronzer, a blush, and then an eyeshadow palette up here. I bought this a while ago, and for me, this was pretty expensive. This was like $25 for this palette at a local Target. And I'm ashamed to say I have not even tried it yet. I was waiting to like pick up more Pixi products, and then like I didn't until now, so it just sat there. Yeah, shame on me. So we've got a good full face palette. Next, I picked up in a random, I think, Ulta order, this Pixi glowy powder. This is in the shade Creamy Gold. So this is a highlighter that I've used a couple of times, and I think it's actually really nice, but again, it was a bit pricey. So I love the packaging. I love the entire aesthetic of Pixi, like the light green with everything. It's gorgeous. Green light, green eyeshadow, green everything. I love it. It's stunning. But the whole point is to show you what I've got and what I'm testing to see whether or not it's actually worth the price. So keeping that in mind. This is a product I've had for a long time, and this is a crayon combo. So this is like a double-sided eyeliner pen where we have a brighten and a lighten. So these are both kind of like nude shimmery, or one's a nude matte and one's a nude shimmer kind of waterline pencil. And I was hoping for it to be something to make me look a little bit more awake in the mornings where I have a bit of some dark circles and everything. So we've got this, and I have used this, and it is pretty nice so far. I don't think this was as expensive as the rest of everything, but of course when I do my final wrap-up video, I will have the prices and I will compare my experience with what they're being marketed for. Alright, so these next products were all placed in one order that I placed a couple of weeks ago. The first product is this Beauty Balm. Now, I really wanted to pick up their other foundation. They have another foundation that's like their bestseller. But of course, it being their bestseller, everything was sold out, so I couldn't get anything. The Beauty Balm is like a tinted like BB cream that they have, and they don't have that many shades, unfortunately. I think there's only like 8 shades. They had more shades in their other foundation, which is why I wanted to try it, but it's been sold out. If I can get my hands on that before I do this final wrap-up video, I'll see if I can, but for now, we've got the Beauty Balm, and I got the lightest shade, number 1 cream, because I am, of course, Casper. I barely leave my house, guys. I don't. Along that same vein, I did pick up their concealer. So this is the concealer in the shade Cream once more, because I am Casper. I have to say, so I've used this a couple of times. This is the strangest, like, doe foot applicator. Let me show you. Look at how weird this applicator is. It's, like, scooped, but, like, it's wide. Oh, it was so weird. So this doe foot applicator was so weird when I first started using it, but I've been using this concealer for a little bit, and honestly, I gotta say, so far I've used the BB cream and the concealer for a little bit. I'm pretty impressed so far, but I have not thoroughly tested them yet. Next, I picked up two products that I was so excited to try because I've been on like this creamy blush kick, and these are their On The Glow blushes. I think these are some of their newest products. So I got this shade, this is, okay, so technically it's a tinted moisture stick, but they're like cream blushes. And this is the shade, where's the shade? Fleur, so like a nice, light, bright pink shade. And then, you know how much I love a good peach blush. I couldn't resist picking this shade up. And this is the shade Juicy, because of course it is. So we've got that right there. I have to say, I'm a bit on the fence about the packaging for these. Like, having it in like such a wide stick like this. Like, I think they're supposed to like go like this. But I've tried that once or twice with some foundations, and it just like lifts my foundation up. So like, I don't know, maybe it's supposed to be only used for like no makeup makeup, but that's what we're gonna find out once I've thoroughly test these. Next, I picked up one of their liquid shadows. So I was gonna pick up a few others. I don't know if I'm going to, if I'm gonna stick with this one. This is their Fairy Lights liquid shadow, and it's in the shade... Oh, I can't even read that. Jesus Christ. Pixi Green, of course it is. So it's in the shade Pixi Green, and I've used this a couple of times. I have to say, I'm not amazed, dazzled by it yet, but I love the packaging. It's got a perfect doe foot for this kind of thing. I love the light green of Pixi, and looking at all the shades they had available, like on Ulta's website, I was so happy to see a light green liquid shadow shade available. So of course, that's what I jumped on. Last but not least, in my last haul, I picked up two of their liquid lipsticks. So I picked up, of course, a good true red. I wish they had a black lipstick, but they did not, unfortunately. So this is the shade Real Red. Very excited. And then I picked up kind of a warm nude kind of shade. This is the shade Oh Naturelle. So yeah, so we got like a more nude, kind of deep nude, and then we've got a nice bright red shade. So that's everything that I bought from Pixi in the last couple of months. Now let's jump into what my good friend Victoria sent me. I have to go ahead and give a big shout out thank you to Victoria. She's more active on Instagram, so I'll have her Instagram and her YouTube channel linked down below. Her YouTube channel is Rare Beauty Envy. I posted about wanting to do a big Pixi haul on Instagram, and I mentioned kind of the products that I wanted to do, and I was asking for suggestions from you guys about what products you knew and could recommend and liked, and Victoria jumped in and said that a lot of the products that I wanted to try she actually had and she wasn't going to use, and I was like, oh hell yeah. So we did a makeup swap, and I'm so excited to try all of these products out. The first one is the big eyeshadow palette I wanted to try. So this is the Natural Beauty palette, and this is just a gorgeous, cool toned palette. Look how stunning this is. I cannot wait to get into this. Next, Victoria sent me two lip products. So this one's a lip gloss, and then this one's a lipstick, the same as the others that I picked up, but this is in the shade Berry Beauty. So it's like a nice berry shade. Very excited about that. And then this lip gloss, can I read? This is in Peony Blossom. That looks gorgeous. I think it actually might look really pretty on top of the berry shade. We'll see. We'll have to try things out and mix and match. Victoria also sent me two of these Endless Shadow Sticks, which I didn't even know Pixi had these. So they're like eyeshadow crayons. I think like, what's the brand that has some of these? Laura Mercier has like stick shadows. And that's kind of the first thing I thought of when I saw these. So we've got two shades here. We've got like a dark brown and a nice light copper shimmer. It looks like the dark brown is a matte shade. Excited to experiment with these. Next, I have this large lash mascara. Now, I have not heard anything good or bad about Pixi's mascaras, but this thing is huge. Like for a mascara, I don't know, just like the size of it was just kind of insane, but I'm excited to finally try out a Pixi mascara. I also got this like little sample or deluxe sample size of a primer. So this is the H2O Skin Drink Pure Hydration Gel Primer. Have not opened it up or tried it out yet, but I'm very excited. I love a good like gel moisturizing primer, and as we are going into winter, hopefully, I'm hoping it's getting colder. This is just what I'm going to need. All right, next we have a Pixi collab palette. So this is from Pixi and Chloe Morello, and I have so much trouble opening. Oh, there we go. I have so much trouble opening the palette. I don't know why, but this is the palette. So we've got some blushes up here, and then these are eyeshadows. And of course, down here, we've got like a unique kind of like, they're not like all in the same pan. They are pan separated, but you've got like these darker shades down here. I kind of thought this was supposed to be like a brow section, right? It's supposed to do your brows and then like the rest of your eyeshadow. But I'm excited to jump into this. And I'm kind of surprised. Why do we have just like a random mirror, like this small mirror? I can barely see my eyes in this. Like, what is the point of this mirror, Pixi? I don't know if this is supposed to be a brush in there, but also, like, why is there a mirror in here? Why? Next, we have this gorgeous glitter quad, which, to be quite honest, I don't know if I ever would have picked something like this up because I'm not usually a huge fan of glitter, but I'm glad I got it. And like, look how pretty those shades are. It's still like wrapped. I haven't even actually opened it yet. So let's open this. Oh, that red for fall and Christmas. Okay. So I have to like dig into these and really try them. They're of course going to need a glitter glue, so a lot of experimenting to be had. Next, unfortunately, this one was a casualty of shipping. This is the, it's like a duo, let me see. This is the Beauty Blush Duo in Peach Honey. So unfortunately it did shatter in shipping. So I repressed it into the shade and you can see now it was duo sided. I'll throw a picture up here of what the original product was supposed to look like. But as you can see, like the final shade came out actually like really pretty. And to be quite honest, I'm not sure if this is going to be a highlight or a blush. We're gonna have to really try it. I have not tried it on my face yet, so we will report back. Last but certainly not least, Victoria sent me a glow mist, so a good setting spray. This is the glow mist with propolis and argan oil. And I have to say, I'm actually really impressed with like the packaging. I've never seen like a setting spray mist that looks like this. And let's give it a good old spray. It does have a really nice fine mist. And it smells very unique. That's what I can say. It's not like bad, but also not like very pleasant. I don't know what I'm trying to say. It's not the best, it's not the worst, but I'm excited to test this. So there we have it. Thank you, Victoria, for sending me all these products, and we've got a full Pixi haul, a bunch of Pixi products. So I'm going to be testing all these products out, and I'll be back in a few weeks, maybe a couple of months, with a full review of all of these products and whether or not I think they are worth the price. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below if you've tried Pixi and what your favorite product from Pixi is, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.